In this tutorial, we're learning how to create a directional blur on our bitmap layers. Now I'm saying bitmap layers, this is really important to understand, is that you cannot apply a blur on a layer that is vector. However, it can be, you know, duplicated and converted to a bitmap layer to apply your blur. So that way you still keep a safe copy, kind of like what I did here. I started off from my layer A, which is a vector layer, as we can see with the gray strip that we have here. You can duplicate it really easily with the button at the bottom right of your layers, and then you end up with a copy of your layer, and you can really easily go and manipulate that to be a bitmap layer by right-clicking on it, and you go to convert to bitmap layer. Now, it's always going to be the first step in applying a blur to your layer, so keep that in mind. Now, once I have my layer here, I'm able to right-click, go on this menu here, which again will be grayed out if you're not on a bitmap layer, and we're going to go to directional blur. Now, in here we have quite a few options that we can look at. If we're looking real quick at those options, we have length, which is essentially going to be the length of my blur. We have width, we have the angle. Now the angle works in a very specific way. I actually have over here an example of just how this would work. So we're always starting off on the left here. This is 0 degrees. It is going to get blurred towards the center here. So in this direction, 90 degrees will blur in the direction that is going downwards. 180 will be the same as zero, except the blur will be going towards the left, and 270 degrees will go up. So anywhere between those values will always kind of go towards the center. So you need to kind of decide which side the blur is going to go. Now, for me, I kind of wanted to stay at 0 degrees and go more towards the right, since my character is going in the opposite direction. So I want that effect that my trees are actually zooming by really fast as my character zooms past them. The fall off that we have over here now, essentially the fall off is going to be the distance where the blur fades from the edge of the image. So how big is it going to go? Is it going to go all the way up to here, all the way up to here? It really depends on the value that you put in here. The biggest value that you're going to put is going to bring it closer to the tree, and the more you go towards 0 and 1, the more it's going to go far away from there so that you can almost not see the image. Now, the number of iterations is basically going to be how many times is the blur applied to your image. Usually I'm fine with leaving this at 1. So the more iterations you have in there, it could consequently make your render time a little bit heavier. So you want to be careful with not using a number that is too high on there. Usually I think 1 does a fine job, but if you want something a little more precise, a little more refined, you could boost that number slightly. So I'm happy with the length right here. Let's try 50 for the fall off, and let's try rendering that to see what it gives us. There we have it. So now our trees over here have been blurred. If we're not happy with that result and maybe we want to blur it a little more, we might try just going back into our directional blur settings. Maybe I could change the fall off rate. Remember I said when we lower this number, the blur is going to be going in directions that are a bit more far away from the actual object. So pressing OK. And there we go. So now my character can actually skate by past those trees, and it's going to look like he's actually not in focus and going faster away from those trees. So there we go. I hope you found this useful. This was how to create a directional blur.